an intercomparison of an NKF data assimilation method with the 3D and 4D variational methods was made using the Weather Research and Forecasting, WRF, model over the contiguous United States during June of 2003. It is found that 4DVAR has consistently smaller errors than that of 3DVAR for winds and temperature L forecast lead times except at 60 and 72 hours when their forecast errors become comparable in amplitude. The forecast error of the NKF is comparable to that of the 4DVAR at the 12 to 36 hours lead times, both of which are substantially smaller than that of the 3DVAR, despite the fact that 3DVAR fits the sounding observations much more closely at the analysis time. The advantage of the NKF becomes even more evident at the 48 to 72 hours lead times. The NKF has recently been applied to the TC initialization problem. The NKF assimilation of inner core data, such as airborne Doppler radar winds, has shown some promising results with improving the vortex structure and intensity forecasts. In Figure 6, the performance of an NKF system for predicting TC intensity is shown for a sample of cases in which airborne Doppler radar data was assimilated, reproduced from. As shown in the figure, average intensity errors were reduced by the NKF assimilation of radar data. Used an ensemble Kalman filter, NKF, to assimilate center position, velocity of storm motion, and surface axisymmetric wind structure in a high-resolution mesoscale model during the 24-hour initialization period to develop a dynamically balanced TC vortex without employing any extra bogus schemes. The surface radial wind profile is constructed by fitting the combined information from both the best track and the Drop-Winsonde data available from aircraft surveillance observations, such as the Drop-Winsonde observations for typhoon surveillance near the Taiwan region, .star. The subsequent numerical integration shows minor adjustments during early periods, indicating that the analysis fields obtained from this method are dynamically balanced. While the NKF methods are appealing, due to its ensemble nature, it can be significantly more costly, in a computational sense, than the variational methods.